Hey guys, Jeff Gellman of Solid Canine Training, handling nervous dogs. We got this dog right in here. He just came in over the weekend. Very nervous, skittish, lunging, barking, you know, a lot of the nonsense that we see. How do we get him out of the kennel? When I approach the kennel, at least when I did this morning, he growled at me. So if I back away, what does that train the dog to do? It trains the dog to keep growling. I gotta get him out of the kennel. He has to do it. So what I'm gonna do is this. I'm gonna get him out with a slip lead, and then once he's out, I'm gonna put the prong on and put a leash on. And I also want folks to know is, using a prong collar and a remote collar for skittish, nervous dogs is probably the best idea. This is a dog, when he gets nervous, for instance, if he was on a harness, or a flat buckle collar, or a martingale, and when you have and you mix those tools with nervousness, you have a dog that you cannot control. The great thing about a prong collar is, if the dog's gonna be nervous, guess what? You can't flee. You can't skitter, you can't scatter. This is what we're gonna do. So, first thing I'm gonna do is I'm gonna open up the kennel door. Now, if he growls at me, I'm not gonna back away from this dog. What I'm gonna do is I'm gonna slip the lead over his neck. I'm gonna do the same protocol though. I'm not allowing this dog to rush out of the kennel. It's really, really important. So now, let's go. Now I get him out of the kennel. See how he's pulling at me right now? This pulling actually harms the dog. So what I immediately do though is I immediately close his kennel up. This is very important. It doesn't give him the opportunity to run back in the kennel. Well, look at him. He's very afraid right now. He's very nervous. I'm not making him nervous. He came to us a very nervous dog. He's only been here for a couple days. I was in New York City yesterday, so this is the first time I've worked with him. But guess what? I'm calm. I'm confident. I'm not gonna baby him, but I'm also not gonna be forceful with him. So, I'm not gonna take him out on a slip lead. I wanna get a training collar on him so we can start going for a walk. So when I'm gonna put my prong collar on him, what I'm gonna do is I'm actually gonna attach the leash to the prong right away. It's just one less step that I've gotta make. Now, I'm not gonna say any words to the dog, because believe it or not, saying words to a dog could make a dog even more nervous. But what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna put the prong collar on. And guys, be careful, this is a great opportunity for the dog to bite you. Keep your faces away from these dogs. But I'm gonna go underneath like this. Now I've got myself on a prong, and then the slip lead is off. So again, notice, I didn't say anything to this dog. I was very methodical, to the point, the dog is nervous. I'm not making the dog nervous. That's why the dog is actually here. We deal with a lot of fearful, scared, nervous dogs. A lot of folks don't, but with our boarding training program, we see them all the time. We get so many dogs that come in like this, but you guys gotta watch. Watch the progression. 1 week, 2 weeks, 3 weeks, massive structure, pack work, swimming work, obedience stuff. We're gonna turn this dog around. Perfect opportunity. We just got a nervous, fearful dog in. You know, so many people use our board and train services. If there's people on the fence or they're concerned or they've heard some bad things about board and trains, I want folks to know on day one of training, what it looks like to do a board and train at my property. So I've got Tove here, fearful, anxious, nervous dog. All we're doing right now is doing sort of like a run through of some commands. We're gonna do sit, down, place, and recall, and a little bit of healing work just to get the dog into some work mode. The dog's gonna be here for 5 weeks. So we want this dog to start understanding. It's like, yeah, this is work. I'm supposed to do this stuff. So let me just give you a couple of minutes of a little routine we would do, and I want you guys to be able to do this at home. I make these videos to help you guys out. Okay, here we go. Up here. Good job, buddy. Good. Sit. Down. Down. really, really gentle. I'm giving him a little bit of foot pressure, a little bit of hand pressure, a little bit of guidance. I'm trying to get this dog to understand, guess what, it's time to work. But this is actually how we work with board and train dogs all the time, especially our nervous, fearful ones. They've got to follow through with the commands the first time. We give them guidance with a leash, we give them guidance with a prong collar, we give them guidance with our energy. We're always upbeat, but we're not overly schoolgirl crazy, because if you, so here we go, I'm not even paying attention. The dog was in a down. I'm gonna actually give him a little bit of information. And he's a whiner by nature, so he whines a lot. It's an objection, he's a nervous dog. But notice how I just put my foot down, he went back into a down. Heel. Good job. Place. Toe here. Good, 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 good. Good job, buddy. Let's go. Place. Good. Toe, heel. Place. Good. So, simple commands, lots of repetition. This is gonna go along with a bunch of structured walks off the property in a really busy area. He does dog-dog socialization, he does swimming, and he does treadmill work as well. So this, a couple hours a day, 2 one-hour sessions like this, on just the obedience work, along with everything else mixed in, totally transform dogs. We also work him inside. He's terrible with children. So I'll do other videos with him later of around my kids. Jeff Gellman, Solid Canine Training, a little behind the scenes look of what we actually do at our board and train program. Guys, I love you.